The following episode was taped in front of a live Twitch audience. We'll try to hold that in. Try to hold it in. Make sure my mic's off, yeah. I recorded 4 episodes of this game, Tharsis, for my YouTube channel. And the first 2 episodes, I had my microphone off. And the first episode being like a very simple explanatory kind of episode. That wasn't good. I'm going to have to re-record the voice on that before I put it up on the YouTube channel. And it will be the first series I put on the YouTube channel besides wrestling stuff. It's the first gameplay series I'm putting on. But this is Tharsis. We're going to play it a little bit. At least 2 runs. Because that, you know, they take about a half an hour each, or to 40 minutes to completion. There are going to be missions in this game. They're coming soon. But for now, it's just a flat out roguelike randomized 9 rounds kind of thing. So I'll explain as I go. But this is also going to go on YouTube. This is going to be the 5th episode. 5th and 6th episode they go on YouTube. So I'm going to address chat questions and the like too during this game. But upload it as a continuation of the series, but with the note that says that I did it on Twitch. Because the one thing I want to do is I want to not play this game offline. Like, I always want to be recording when I play this game, because I've been doing pretty well with it, and I like the streaking aspect of it. A lot of people complaining the game is really hard, even on normal mode. But if we go to the stats here, I've played 7 games. I've won 4. Each of those wins, I brought every single crew member to the front of the ship and landed them on Mars. So, what does that mean? I'll explain as I go. So, we'll start a game here. We have some options. Your basic resolution, texture quality, volume. You know, nothing spectacular here. Crew members. You start with the 4 on top, and then you get these next 5 based on achievements. Do 300 researches, do 2,800 repairs, eat 120 human meals. The pilot was done because I won the game. I landed on Mars once. And the technician I got when I think it was 20 food I harvested in the ship. 20 food items. We'll call them pellets. We'll call it Soylent Green. I got 20 units of Soylent Green. And I unlocked the technician. For the sake of the game, the simplicity of the game, at least on normal mode, you don't get any better than your 4 main characters. Kayla Joines gives 1 health to each crew in the module if she rolls her special ability. Allison can re-roll 1 more time. Everyone can re-roll once, so your initial roll and then 1 re-roll. Allison can re-roll an additional time, so she can have 3 total rolls in any module. Pascal can heal the ship, give the ship HP. And Jean can add dice to the crew. Every time you use a turn, you lose a die on each person. So we're going to start with the regular crew members here. As you can see, the stars mean how many times they've landed on Mars. The skulls mean how many times they have died in the mission. I played 7 games. I've won 4. So that's why everyone's 4 and 3. So we'll do this.
Once. We can't turn back, but how can we go on?
It's always something. I didn't have the sound for the game on because I had the music on, so always something. All right, here we go. So we got 4 crew members scattered among the ship. Each of these parts of the ship is called a module. These little triangles, these are your events. These are the things that every wave, you get pretty much 1 to 3 of these to hit the ship. One might just be on the last wave, but 2 to 3 mostly. And you have to take care of this. The number means that's the number you have to roll within the module to repair the ship. the red area is the damage or whatever, the attribute that's going to happen in between rounds. So if I don't clear this, everyone gets minus one health. If I don't clear this, that means the ship's going to take one damage. Up here on the upper left-hand corner is our ship HP, the impending damage, so you can see, like, really quick at a glance how the damage is going to affect you going into next turn. If I don't repair this, I still have 3 HP going into next turn. If I don't repair this, everyone loses health. Health is on the right-hand side of the character card. The amount of dice you have is on the bottom of the character card. This level over here is stress. Stress affects the, from what I know, stress affects the choices you're given in between rounds. And when you're, you know, stuff like the add one dice to all member, but lose one health. Like, you'll have choices in different scenarios, and I'll show you them as soon as we're done with this first wave. Each module has a specialty. Allison up here, she can increase assists if she rolls 5 or more and puts it in the module specialty. Assists negate status effect dice. Those are here. See this 1 in 3, it's blue? Those are stasis die. If I roll those, I can't re-roll that die, unless I have an assist. And the assists go automatically, I can't pick and choose. So if I roll a 3, it will use an assist. If I roll 2 threes, one will use an assist. The other will be in stasis. I can't re-roll it for the duration of that player's turn. Other things, like I can repair the ship, I can regain dice, I can harvest food, blah, blah, blah. So there are also two other status die. An orange die will decrease your health if you roll it, which is devastating if you roll multiples. And the purple one is a void die. If you roll it, that dice just disintegrates. You can't use it during the turn. You don't lose it for next turn, but you just can't use it anymore at that point in time. So I'll explain a little bit more as I go. Down here, we have cards. There's a research area. If any extra dice or whatever, there's dice labeled 1 to 6. You can put them into this area, and the pink number means that that's how many die you have to have saved down there to use the card. Pretty much. So let's see what we want to do here. We're pretty low on dice. We're pretty okay on health, except for Kayla. So I think what we do is we're going to bring these 3 crew members up into this module and roll with the captain last, because the captain's specialty adds a die to everyone who's in that module. And remember, you lose a die every turn. 1 is the lowest, you can't go to 0. So at the end of this turn, Jean, Pascal, and Allison will all be at 0 die, 1 die. So maybe Jean can bump it up to 2 by the end of the turn. We'll start with Allison here because Allison can reroll an extra turn. 1 and 4, 1 is a stasis die. I used my last assist on that. 4 is a good enough number. This area here holds the dice so you don't re-roll it, and then gives you the option to decide what you want to do with it after you've seen all the rolls. So let's see what happens here. No 1, no 3, 1. 1 goes into stasis. I think for the sake of this, I'm going to put the 4 into the repair, bring it down to 23. 1 up here doesn't really do us that much, so we're going to put it into the research projects and bank it for now. You can't add multiple of the same number down here. Pretty much you have to have 1 of each number if you want to put 6 dice down here. You can re-roll the cards at the cost of one of the research points. Each die is a point. Not, it doesn't have to do with the value. It has to do with how many dice you have in there. So at the cost of 1, you can re-roll the cards if you don't like the cards. Another thing to remember is that the research projects are used left to right, lowest to highest. So if I did this duct tape, it would use the 1. If I had any other dice in here, like the 1 and a 5, anything I use uses the 1. If I had 4 dice in here, it would use the first 4. So if you save a 6, save a 5, or whatever, it wouldn't use those right away. It uses the 1s going up. So I'm done in here. There's nothing more I can do. So I'm going to finish the deployment. I have to get rid of this, but for these crew members to travel up to that module, they have to pass through this event. When that happens, they're going to take movement damage through the event, through the damaged part of the ship. So if I bring Pascal up here, let's say, he's going to lose health. So to not lose health, I have to take care of this event first. So I'm going to move Kayla there. It's only a 10. 1 in 3 are stasis dice. I don't have any assists, so I really have to stay away from the ones. So I got 2 stasis die right now, but in the end, everything here equals a 10. So I can risk re-rolling the 2 and the 4, because I can't re-roll the 1 and the 3, remember, they're in stasis. I can risk re-rolling the 2 and the 4. But I would need to get a total of 6 out of these 2 dice to clear the event. Best case scenario is one die is a 6 and the other die is a 5 or more to give her health, or any number to regain dice. But if I roll another 1 and a 3 or a 1 and a 1, everything's in stasis and I can't get out of this module. I won't clear it and I'm going to have to take damage to go to the other one, or I'm going to have to send a second person in here to clear it. And the way I play the game is you can't let these modules pile up, because next week you're going to get more events. Oh, sorry, you can't let the events pile up. Next week you're going to get more events, and then that's not good. You really can't recover. That's where you get like into where you start having a bad time. Something to consider with my cards down here is that I can repair 17 points of damage on this module if I have 4 research dice, or 3 if I have 1. I have 1 right now. The only way I can get to 4 is if everyone rolls a unique number. And if that happens, I only limit this by 17. I will never put points up there. So no matter what, I am not getting rid of this damage this turn. Everyone's going to lose health. So since that's the case, I may want to consider farming another module to better myself next turn. And what could I farm here? I could farm the greenhouse for dice, but I have to have 2 dice that match to get 1 unit of Soylent Green for the next turn. Each food you eat in between rounds adds 3 dice, by the way. I need that. I need food. But I only have 1 person who's capable of rolling doubles, and they have to be like exact. I either have to take a guess and save a die from the first roll, or they have to be doubles right away. And Jean can't. Jean can also roll for dice because of her specialty. Now, another thing I didn't mention is that if I save a die into the greenhouse, anybody else can come in here and add to that. So if I save a 3 on Pascal, Jean can go in there, roll a 3, and add it to the food harvest, and then get the food. If I were to health recover, let's say, over here, the second unit that goes into there can't utilize that specialty because we've already used it for this week. The other person's die would be in there and it doesn't expand. We can't do 2 things at once. So whatever the specialty is of the module, it's a per week thing. So if you add die into the slot, it stays. So what do I want to do here? I want to really want to get food. But regain dice seems pretty sweet too, because, well, let's do Jean first. No. Yeah, let's do Jean first. Because regain dice, I need doubles, but the first die that goes in there, I get 2 dice. So whatever she rolls, or he rolls, I think it's a he. It's a 6. Now, I can add 1 die to Jean and 1 die to Kayla right now. Or I can add 2 die to Jean. But if I do this, then when Pascal comes in here, he needs to roll a 6 to get 2 dice himself, because they have to equal. I think I'm going to give 1 to Kayla, 1 to Jean, then bring Pascal in there as well, and roll. If I did Pascal first, he could have gotten an extra dice from that. But he can go full on dice now. He gets 4 extra dice for next turn. So my dice situation is now better because I can give Allison food and then Jean can just be a two.
Moods are turning sour, the crew's and my own. But if I can't lead them, we're all dead. I need to get it together.
All right, so here are our choices. We get this in between every week. If you see up here, it's now 9 weeks to Mars. So basically 9 sets of turns, and then I'm at my objective. No movement damage, so I won't take damage moving in between events, but everyone in this group will have minus 1 die. Plus 1 food, but minus 1 dice for all crew. So this is like a net gain for one person. Everyone loses a dice, so Kayla would go to 3, Jean to 1, Allison would stay at 1, Pascal to 4. I'd have 2 total food, so I could bring Jean and Allison right back up to 4 dice. I think I'd do this. Now I have 2 food. Like I said, Allison's going to get 1, and Jean's going to get 1. It's going to add 3 dice to both of them. So I'm good on dice now. Kayla's health is at 1, Allison's at 2, Pascal at 4, Jean at 3. So I really want to keep that in the back of my mind. Health. Let's see what happened here. So, a 16 event, minus health all. We still have that 23 event, minus 1 health all as well. And now we have a new 11, 1 damage to the ship. So the ship is in good shape. This 16 right here has an injury die. So that's something to be scared about. I want to take Kayla in here, because with 3 dice, she should be able to roll an 11. Best case scenario, she rolls an 11 and like a 6 and a 5 and another 6 or 5. So I can use this module's specialty and get her to full health. And I have the duct tape card to repair 3 with 1 module. So I really need 8 on 2 dice and the 5 and above. I have 1 assist, so I have to avoid 1s and 2s. And there is 8. There is... So I use the card. It uses the die. I go down to 0 research projects. Reduces this by 3. There's my 8. And there's my 5. Gives her full health. We cleared the event. We sorted her health problems. So the injury die here, I really want assists to go in there, because I really don't want to injure anybody. Allison would never go in here because she's too low on health. So I'll probably send Pascal in there first. 4 dice to roll a 16. That's 4 per die on average. He can do it. And then if not, I send Jean in afterwards to further reduce it and to add a die to both of them. But I gotta take care of one of these minus health walls, because as it stands now, we have 2. That would mean Allison dies. So let's bring Allison in here. No injuries to worry about, just have to avoid stasis dice. High rolls are preferred. We're gonna save the 5. Let's see, 5, 4, 4 is 9. 9 and 3, 13. So with a 23, I need a 6 on 3 dice and a 5 on 1. I doubt I'm going to get that and avoid 1s and 3s. But at the very least, I want to get a 5 to increase our assists to maximum. You can only have 3 assists. This will give you 3 assists, but it'll be diminishing returns. But we'll see if we can waste one of them here. Anyway, not only do we waste 1... but we also got another stasis die. Reroll the last. It's a 5. Good. All right. So that means I can put the 5 here, get 3 more assists, use the 11 towards the repair, and then put the 1 here. I probably could have put them all in research projects, but I really want to chip at this so that next turn it's guaranteed that I take 1 person in here and it's done. Now let's bring Pascal in here. Roll with 4 dice, injury dice, stasis, but we have 3 assists. We used one assist on the injury die. The 6 and the 5 are the good. I'm going to bank those for now and see what to do with them. Because another two more 5s would be ideal. I could put one towards the ship repair and then I can just clear this this module out. 6 and 6. Look at these rolls. They're fantastic. Now, I could harvest food here. But I just want to get rid of this module. So, there's 12. And then, you know, you can obviously go over the repair. You don't have to be exact. And then we'll give the ship some HP because that'd be nice for the future rounds to come. So Pascal got that sorted with some good rolls. Now I could bring Jean in there, farm for food, farm for extra dice. Or I can bring Jean to Kayla. I think we're going to farm food because Kayla would just get one. Jean would get one to stay at 4 dice, or I can farm food, and then Kayla can go to 5 next turn. 5 dice, that is. Best case scenario here is I farm for food and give Jean and Pascal extra dice. An extra die, single die. But I need 5s or more, and this is pretty much the opposite of 5s or more. And they weren't doubles anyway. Okay, so here we go. Doubles on the harvest food means one extra unit of food. Plus 5 there means that Jean and everyone else in the module, Pascal, get an extra die for next turn. And we'll use the 6 in the research projects. No events. One event carrying over. I could have brought Jean up there, honestly. Gotten rid of that.
I let my fear get the better of me, but the others have proven me wrong. I'm proud of how the crew has come together. I think we might actually have a chance.
So that last turn, I prioritized getting a unit of food over clearing all the units, you know, clearing all the events out. Because of that, I suffered damage for everybody. Meaning I can't take this card right here that gives everyone dice and minus 2 health. I couldn't have taken it either before because Allison would have only had 2 health. This kills Allison. We don't want to do that. Plus 1 food and minus 2 ship. Well, Pascal got us 1 extra HP that turn. Minus 2 ship is not devastating. So we take this and we get an extra unit of food. We'll give the food to Kayla. Remember, it gives you 3 dice. So I don't like to give it to like Allison here. Because you get like a little bit of diminishing return. Unless everyone was at 3, I probably would never give out food. If everyone's at 3, I'd probably bump somebody up. But everyone has more than 3 here. Allison is in bad shape. Low health. Low dice. We'll see if we can get her into this unit right here. And get her health to max at least. Now, here we go. Void dice, 2 and 3. If I roll any of them, they just disappear. I have a card that prevents void, but I need 4 points of research. This is the big one, the CCC leak. Injury die, but if I roll a 1, it's 3 damage. So rolling like 4 dice is scary in there because, you know, one of them, rolling 1-1 without an assist is 3 damage. Rolling 2 ones is 6 damage. That will kill anyone. We have to absolutely get rid of this while we have assists. Who do I do it with, though, is the question. 2 people are already in this module. I can move Kayla into here, roll with Kayla, hopefully clear the event, and give everyone extra health. Or I can roll with Jean and give everyone an extra die that's in there. I think I want to roll with Kayla here. Clear the event and give everyone extra health. And if anything's left over, then roll with Jean and hopefully give everyone die, clear the event, and harvest food. Clearing this will bring our impending damage down to 1 because only this unit will remain. An 18 and a 14 are pretty low. So I should be able to clear that with 1 person in each. Or at the very least, I have a 17 card. I could try for that. I don't have to roll 18. I just have to roll two unique dice down here to really clear that with a one. So let's bring Kayla into here. Yeah, die is singular of dice, and it's tricky when you're announcing, you know, when you're trying to commentate for this, because you're just like screwing up die, dice, and the like. The game does say like one dice on the card, so it's like a singular plural thing. So no ones. I don't use any assists here. Okay, I have doubles. So that's 6, 11, 14. So I can reroll the 3. This is the scary situation. I know I have this event cleared. I can reroll this 3. I would need a 7. No, I won't. I would need a... I would need a 7. That's good math. I would need a 5 or a 6 on this reroll to clear the repair and use the doubles over here and harvest one unit of food. I know I wanted to give everyone health, but I have the chance to get food. Food trumps health, I think. It's still a 3. So now I have to see what 16 is. That's okay. So here's 17. No assist used, and we cleared out this bad boy. And we give everyone in the module here, Pascal, Jean, and Kayla, 1 HP. I think that was pretty solid for that. Now that we have the assists, I think we go here. We kept the assist, I should say. I think we go here and try to get rid of this system failure. And we'll do it with Jean. Because if we bring Pascal down here, we can use any extra die to roll for a ship HP. So I think we bring Jean here. Any 2s and 3s will use an assist, but beyond the assist, they will just get rid of the dice. There's 2 assists. We're going to keep the 6. And 18 is an average of about 4.5 per die. So we need 8. We need a roll of an 8 here. A 5 and 3, a 2 and a 6, a 4 and a 4. Wow. That's amazing. I am amazing. So 12, 16. I have to use every die here. 6 and 6 is 12, plus 5 is 17. Or I get sneaky. I use the 4 and the 5 here. Use the 17 card. Now, why use the 17 card when I can keep it in my back pocket for something else? I already have the rolls needed for this repair. So, get rid of it and be done with it. 2 events left. Allison up here with the minus health all. So, 2 things to consider here. I can put Pascal here in the minus health all, and then move Allison to the medical bay and roll for full health. Or I can use Allison to try to clear this and use Pascal to try to clear this. And then go into next event with nothing on the board. I worry about Allison's health, and if I get her to full health, then maybe like one of my actions in between rounds will be like minus 2 health plus 1 die for all or something. And I wouldn't have the health to sacrifice to do something like that. So I think I'm going to bring Pascal up here. Clear this event, and that will allow Allison to move out of this area. Okay, I used an assist there. So if I can re-roll that die to a 2 or more, I can clear everything and boost my assists again. So there's my 2. So 5, 5, and 2 is... 12. This event is cleared. Do I want 1 ship health or do I need 1 assist? I think I want the assist. Every round you get 1 assist. But if I bring it up to maximum, then at least I could like mitigate damage done next round. If there's like a lot of health. A lot of like health dies. I'm sorry, injury die. Now Allison can freely move out because this event is cleared and I can bring her down to the medical bay. Any 5 or more, and she's at full health. She has no specialty. Her specialty is to reroll. one additional time. So I can't, you know, I can't use that as specialty by putting a 5 or more there. It's just automatically done. So I put the 5 there. She gets the full health. And it's unfortunate that I can't put another die down here to research projects because it's, you know, a duplicate. And I can't even use a card to free up. So that's a strategy, too. If this was a 1, I might have wanted to play a card, get rid of... play a card, get rid of the 1 to put the 1 back in there. That's a strategy to think about as well. But my 1 card, first of all, I'm max assist. This does nothing for me. And it would take away left or right, so it would take away the 1. I still can't add the 2 in there no matter what I do. So we'll leave the module with the 1 die still left on the table. Impending damage from that 1 unit, and we'll see what our choices are.
I've checked our food stores, and it looks grim. We lost more than half our supplies with the module. If we don't find some creative solutions, we'll starve before we ever reach Mars.
Leaving that one event, man, it lingers. It lingers and it stacks up. You see, I've left it from many turns before and I haven't had... Well, no, I think I... Did I clear all the events last round? I don't think I did. Plus 1 ship, minus 1 dice. We don't want that. Minus 30% stress for you guys. Yeah, it's the better of the two. I really don't want to lose dice here. We have 1 food. We can give it to Allison. Now, here's the thing. Few weeks into the mission, there's a tutorial mission, and the tutorial mission has to do with a part of the ship that doesn't exist anymore. It just shows you how to roll and what to do and stuff like that. It was basically the pantry. So, like, any roll of 1 or above added, like, 3 food in the pantry. Like, it was, like, such a simple mission. But we hit a meteor. And that part of the ship was destroyed. We lost 1 crew member, and 1 crew member on the ship died because of the damage. Cannibalism. That 1 crew member that died that was on the ship, we can now eat. It adds 2 dice. You lose 1 maximum overall health. So you it's like a heart container. You'd lose the heart container. It wouldn't damage you 1. It would permanently damage you 1 unit. So we could only go to 5 max HP if we used it. Plus, it pretty much brings you to maximum stress. So it's like a worst-case scenario thing. There are benefits to using it. Obviously, the 2 dice is big. The other benefit to using it is that there is an achievement and a character locked behind eating human meat. So I think because of that, we're going to be a cannibal. Because we need to for an achievement and an unlock. That's something I might not have done. But we need to get there eventually anyway. So I can't just rest on not doing it. Plus there's an achievement for not being a cannibal throughout the remainder of the mission. I already got that. So we're good. The meteor strike was on the tutorial week. I didn't have that box. Since I've played the game more than once already, I didn't have that box checked anymore. So we never saw the meteor part. See this part of the ship up here? If you can see my mouse, I think you can see my mouse pointer. This part of the ship up here is the pantry. That was the tutorial. Was like, take this person, go up here, and then like you had like 1 roll, and then that was it. And then the meteor struck and hit this part of the ship. 19, 18, 14. Only one damage. One damage dice, injury die. No void dice, which is good. Pascal is already up here, but I really want to consider what I have to do here. Everyone's good on dice. Jean could stand to get health. But Jean can't clear this. Well, she can clear this with, or he can clear this with 4 dice, the 18. And then roll a 5 or better to get the full health there. So I don't need to pile people into the terminals. And with these assists, I think my best chance is to roll with Pascal in here. Or roll with somebody else in there. And then roll with Pascal in the maintenance area to get to farm ship HP. Let's see if I can clear this stuff first. But in what order? Well, like I said, I want Jean in here. See if I can clear this and get her, get him full health recovery. There's my meaty cannibalized dice right there. I've used 2 assists already. Not happy about it, but in a way, I don't really care. Oh man, look at those low numbers. Oh, Yahtzee! That was terrible. All right, well, since we have to bring somebody else in here anyway, let's just go ahead and get the full health. Contribute 8 into here. We can't even use the... We can't even put anything down here because we rolled 6s and 2s. So I can't even use that 17 repair card. So that went bad. That went bad. We cleared 8 off the terminal, but we got Jean full health. Okay, I guess. Now we can bring Allison in there. If we did it the other way around, we probably could have gotten Allison to die. 3 stasis die, but we rolled 19. So I think we just clear this. This is 7. You know what? I think we just rolled the 2 sixes. The worst that can happen is they're both ones and then we re-roll. Anyway. Because we got that extra reroll. But 6s do us no good down there. And I'd rather clear this with 3 dice than 4. Honestly. And then we do something like that. Where we can't even use the 2 now. Alright. Well, either way, because the 6 wasn't usable down here. The 2 is not usable down here. It's unfortunate I'm getting this. I mean, I could re-roll. I'm going to use the assist. See what the new card is. It's prevent injury with 6. Prevent void 7. I really hate to lose this repair module here. So that's why I'm not going to re-roll. Because this is a nice, you know, any 1 and 3 that would be that would do 4 bits of repair, that 4 would then be 17 repair in there. So I think I'm just going to save that. Leave the module. So 2 people left. The 19 and the 14. Well, we got the assist from the card. So let's try to save damage. Unless he rolls 5 threes. He should live beyond this roll and this turn and meaty die. So there's 1 3. Use the assist. I rolled a 17, but I can do better than 6 for 3 dice total. So let's do that. Let's re-roll. Alright. 5, 2, 1. That's 19 total. And I have no more re-rolls anyway. So everything goes in there. Sad I couldn't farm ship health. I probably could have put 2 dice down there, used the 17 and gotten the ship health. But again, if I can clear the repair and save that 17 card, I'm going to do that long term. Now we have 1 more unit, 1 more module left, 1 more event left. So Kayla comes in here. No assists, so stay away from the 1s and the 2s, please. 14 on 4 dice should not be that bad. And in fact, that's 15. We just go with the 15. Done. We wiped off all the events, so there's no damage, no health penalties, no dice penalty.
A transmission arrived. Not from Earth, but from Mars. From Tharsis. An impossible signal from an impossible source. Is this what we're searching for? Who's transmitting this signal? Was there another mission to Mars? One sent before ours? Or is the message coming from someone else?
All right, 3 choices this time. When the stress gets high, like people, it's almost like they're too stressed out to work as a team. So you have your own, you know, they have their own, like whatever you want to call these things, scenarios or whatever, choices to make. Most of them always do additional stress if you do not choose them. If they're that stressed out, they add more stress. So let's see what our choices here. Plus one food, minus one health for these two who are at max health and are not penalized because of the cannibalism. That's good. Minus 20% stress for all crew. Minus one ship. We want ship HP. This will give us ship HP, but two less health on you. The first two choices give Gene extra stress. Gene's choice gives no one else extra stress. But it just adds ship HP at the penalty of two health for Gene. I kind of like the food because I'm going to need food for next turn. Kayla's going to need food next turn to bump her back up to five dice. I think we do that. We bank the food. We sacrifice the health. We hold on to everything here. But I do want to eat human for the achievement and the unlock. I guess I can do it now. No, I'll do it next turn. Next turn, I'll give Kayla three dice and I'll give one of these dudes the leftover human. 24. Okay, 24 is big. 8's not that big. 24 is big. Injury die on a high number. Void die on a decent number. And then a stasis die here. So 1s and 2s we can reroll. 6s are free. And then we have to worry about the 5s and the 4s. Two people trapped here that can't move out without damage. Pascal's trapped up here. He can't go anywhere else without sustaining damage or taking damage. I think we one assist though. I could roll Pascal here for the assists. I'd rather roll Pascal here because this is extra ship HP. I think we man up. We roll. We try to get a decent amount taken off here. And between Gene and Allison, I think we take this out. Allison first, Gene second, so Gene could give a. Well, in any order, Gene could give extra die, but at least with Gene second, we know what we could, what we can sacrifice and what we can't. So the 5 is okay. 2 6s is spectacular. 12, 17, 17 and 6. No, seven. It would be 17 and 7. So the only way to get rid of this is if she rolled 6 on every die, and that's not good. I think we contribute it all. Can't put the 2 down there. Can put the 5 down there, but only gives us 14 to clear. If I reroll the 2, I risk losing the die. I lose risk injury. But really, what's the risk after all, right? Just a game. So there's an injury at the cost of a 5. So that's 22 towards the repair. I think we do that. Then pretty much any roll of Gene. Gene's first roll clears this unless it's all 4s. And we have extra dice to play around with to roll for plus one die for everyone in the module. Now consider this. If I do clear this terminal, I can use my extra rerolls for this stuff still. But if I clear the terminal, the injury, the void, the stasis, they go away. And my second reroll is then free. I just have to stay away from stasis carries over after you clear the module, clear the event. So void, that will go away. 6 into the repair, clears the ship. 6 here, gives a die to Gene and Allison since she's in the module as well. And we gotta hope for not a 6 and not a 2. So there's a 1. We'll put the 1 down here. So if I rolled a 4 there, since I cleared the event on the roll before, the 4 would not be a void die. It's done. The dangers are over. So we'll put the 1 down there. And we're done. Now we have two people left for one event that's an 8. Kayla there. Any 1. 1s and 3s kill us. But I think you have the ability to get an 8. There's the 8 right there. Awesome. 8. I could give one health to Kayla, but let's reduce stress. Makes the choices better for next turn, hopefully. And now Pascal will come here to maintenance. And with four dice, any double is plus two ship HP. Any five or more is plus one ship HP. A triple would be three ship HP. So let's just hope for four of a kind that are fives or more. There's our ones. So put the ones over here. Both of them. The second one gives us two HP for our ship. This five gives us another HP for our ship. And let's hope for another one. Three is good. Three is in research project. 17 repair to one module is now available for next turn. No events left.
That suit, it's designed for the Ektomi. Nobody has them but us. So who are they? And where did they get them?
Probably eBay. Probably got them on eBay. All right. Gene's still at max stress. I mean, listen, I made him eat a person, so we'll forgive him. Pascal, too, max stress. Maybe you can't reduce their stress if they ate a person. Maybe that's why it's pinged to the top here at red. I don't know much about that, but okay. Minus 30% stress for all crew, minus one ship. We just harvest three ship HP. This should be okay. They'll get plus 10% stress, and I don't know if that's like additive or multiplicative. So I don't know if it's minus 30% stress, then add 10% stress, or if it's, you know, add 10% stress, then minus 30% is what I'm saying. One plus food, minus three health for you. That will bring you down to one health. Minus 30% stress for you, minus one health all crew. Well, that's pretty selfish of you, Gene, for being a captain. I like having the food. Excuse me. Sorry. I like having the food. I can deal with losing the ship and stress. But again, I don't know if, since they ate a person, if they could even have their stress managed. This brings him to one health, but he's only one module away from the health, from the medical bay. So I could probably get away with this and bring him in there and bring him to full health. Let's do that. Kayla's gonna eat food. And everyone else here is fine. I can give Pascal more here, but I just need him to roll a five in the medical bay on three dice with a reroll. So I think we're fine for now. And next turn, we'll give Pascal the food. All right, so lots of void dice over here. Lots of void dice on good numbers. This is probably an area where I want to roll. Or I can use prevent void for the whole turn. Sacrifice the 17 repair module for now. The guaranteed 17 repair. And then prevent void. Then this is pretty much a free roll. And it's 2 damage for the ship. I want to take care of that. Minus 2 health wall is big. Minus 1 health wall is big. Because Pascal right now is at 1 HP. So either of these two will kill Pascal. I think we prevent void. Have Allison take care of this. No, have Allison take care of this with prevent void because it's they're free rerolls. Have Kalik take care of this. Maybe move Gene in here to take care of this. And then Pascal to the medical bay. Pascal has to get out of here. This is important. So maybe I want to reprioritize what I'm doing here. This is the most important to us right now. Minus two health all. If I clear this, I can ignore this. Excuse me, basically. Because I can take Pascal to the medical bay. I have to clear this. I have to clear it and I have to use this card. So now prevent void is not just for one turn, it's for basically the duration of the turns in the week. Take Allison here. I need a 5-5-5-6 to really get rid of this on one turn. Fours hurt me. Fours certainly hurt me. So I don't think I want to risk re-rolling them. I don't think I'm going to get 5-5-5-6 anyway. There's two more fours. Oh boy. Okay. Well, I could get ship repair here too, but I have to get rid of this. I mean, that was bad. That was bad. I'm gonna put one down here because I have the +3 health to one crew. So I can probably use that on Pascal now. But Allison's in bad shape here. And if you don't have those assists, it can go pretty bad. Gene here now has decent amount of HP, maxed 5 of 5. And then add one dice to everybody here. Would be nice. So the void was blocked because I have the prevent void. There's 11. So we cleared it no matter what, but we want another 5 at least. There's our 5. So to do some math here. Best thing I can do is give everyone a die, clear the event, put the one down here, and be done with it. Now Pascal can move to the medical bay. And Kayla has to take care of this, because if I don't have the prevent void past this turn. So I have to go do that. If I use the 17 repair to one module, I have to bring somebody into the module and use it, and then that there starts the turn. So it's not like I can hit 17 repair module, use it on this, and then take Pascal somewhere else. But it might be advantageous, actually, to bring Kayla into here, farm for the 17 repair, and then bring Pascal into here to use the 17 repair. Because Allison is now in danger of dying if I leave this open. So if I bring Pascal into the medical bay, he'll go to full health. Allison will die next turn because of this event. If I bring Kayla into here to clear this event, then Pascal can go into here and use the 17. Tricky, because Kayla has 5 dice working on a number 13. I would for sure have extra dice to put into research, giving Pascal the free 17 damage repair number, and then he just needs to roll a 3. But there's no benefit in this module. If I did it reverse, Kayla to here, she'd have to clear 20 and bank to die. That sounds harder. But the trade-off is Pascal can get extra dice if he's doing this way. I have to do it this way. I have to put Kayla in here first. And there's injury. It is an injury die in here too. So Pascal is at 1 health. He has to avoid ones at all costs. So I'm glad I did it this way. Because of strats. I can now bank a 5. Let's see. Bring the 3s up here. 3 5s up here. Trying to see how I can do this. I have a 20. I can re-roll the 1 at the risk of another damaging myself more. No, it doesn't matter. We clear it first, so the next roll is a 3. Free. We bring the 5 down here. And then any 2, 3, or 6 I can add to here. Any 5 I can give Kayla health. Any 1 or 4 I can regain dice on Kayla. Or a die for next turn. So it's a 1. I can't put it into research. I'll put it here. Full dice for next turn. I think I handled this the right way. Now Pascal goes into here. He doesn't go into here with the 17 repair done. But any 2, 3, or 6. And he has 17 repair. And there's no damage in here. And the void dice will get blocked. So of course they're 1s and 5s. I need a 2, 3, or 6, not 1s and 5s. So let's try it again. There's a 2. Okay. So I put the 2 down here. I use it. This goes down to 3. I use the 1 and the 2 up here. Movement damage does me no good because it's the last person moving this and there's only one event left. Oh, no events left. One ship is okay, but I think the six in research projects is better. And we'll move on. I think that was handled very well, actually.
The more I see of this video, the more it scares the shit out of me. Who are they? What's going on here? What have we gotten ourselves into?
Alright, we have choices to be made. We have three people who are just like max stressed out. They're just like, this guy's biting his lip. Alright, plus 2 food but minus 4 health. So Kayla would sacrifice herself to give us 2 food. Plus 1 health for you but minus 1 ship. That's looking like the best option right now. Minus 30 stress for you, minus 1 health all crew. That would kill 2 people. Plus 1 ship, minus health all crew. So, 3 of these options... deal with killing people. This is the only one. I have 5 ship health, so sacrificing health, ship health for 1 HP, adding stress to these two. At this point, I guess like stress doesn't even matter to me. 4 weeks to Mars. This guy's already stressed out, but he already ate a human. But I guess it doesn't matter. Next turn I can give you the food and give someone else. So I'm always in this position, and it's good because I've been adding dice through Gene's rolls. It's good. I think I'm going to stay like this for now and see what we have here. 25 with a double injury die and then a 9 with a void die, and it's a 1. So it's like, okay, who cares if I lose the 1, right? 2 events is not bad. How do we maximize our turns here? We have 1 assist, so I think I want to take the lowest amount of dice up there. Most likely we use the assist. No, he will die. He will die if he rolls 2 threes, though. We don't want that. So we actually have to bring the person with the most health up here first. Clear out as much as we can with the assist, then I think we bring Kayla in after. Yeah. And then we'll have the lower health people roll here. And then put one of them into the medical bay. Probably Allison into the medical bay. Then she'll be sorted on HP. Let's do this first. We have 1 assist. 4 dice, so best case scenario here is we knock off at least like 12 on the repair and get 3 more assists for Kayla to come in here afterwards. No injury dice. 6, 6, 4. I think that's good. Diminishing returns. I'm putting the 6 here in the assist, but I want to get rid of this, like, stand a chance to get rid of that assist first. And it's a 1, huh? 1 in research projects, 6 into the assist. So now Kayla can come in here and not worry about double damage for more rolls. Because she has 5 dice. And we leave this with a 15. Didn't add a die, but we took off a decent amount, an acceptable amount there. I could also bring Allison up here first because of the assist. But again, if Allison rolls quad 3s, she's done. So at least you can, on a bad roll, you can stay alive. So double 3s takes away 2 assists. That's, let's see, we have 6, 7, 8, and that's 14. So I don't know if we're staying away from this. 11, 17. So I have to use every die here. Actually, that's not true. 11, 17, yeah. I have to use every die here. Now, why am I... I'm trying to add it to 19 for some reason. Because if you see up here, 19 is what I total rolled. Free reroll. 5 or more gives Gene and Kayla 1 more health. Gene's at max health, though. So pretty much I'd be rolling just for plus 1 health on Kayla. I think this is better because this will give 3 health on anybody. Or it goes a long way to prevent injury as well. So we'll do that. Now, between Allison and Pascal, we got the void. We have 1 assist, a void die of 1. Who do I want to bring to the medical bay, though? It's really a toss-up. Allison will have more dice next turn, but Pascal I'm using the food on anyway. So Pascal will have more dice next turn. And with Allison, I can use this card right here. Everyone's health will be sorted. Allison just has to roll a 9 or above, avoid the ones, and she has the extra reroll. So first things first, let's give her the health. Let's roll. Let's not roll 6 million ones. That is an Angry Larry roll for sure. 9. Reduce the stress. Bank the 6. No events left. Pascal to the medical bay. Pascal to the medical bay. 5 or more. There's our 5. Done. 3, 4. Playing very well here. Three more rounds left. Let's see what our things are. No movement damage. Minus 1 dice for you people. I don't like minus 1 dice. We just put you in the medical bay. And you're going to get 1 more die for 2 health. I'm going to give you the food anyway. And 1 more food and minus 3 health for you. You can sacrifice the 3 health. Pascal will get more stress, but he's already tweaking. 1 more die for him is insufficient. And movement damage. I never really liked movement damage. Or no movement damage until like the last round anyway. For reasons I hope to show you guys. I think we do this. I think we shoot you in the kneecap and we take some food. I don't know where the food comes from though. It's not a cannibalized food, but were you just like holding it or something, dude? That's not cool. Pascal with food. I really would like to get more dice here. Gene already took the hit on the max HP. So I think we're just going to feed somebody Allison. Now, when I have no food left, no human meat left, I can kill somebody for 3 pieces of human meat. So I can really be a cannibal. But I won't do that. If somebody dies during the course of the game, too, their meat gets added as well. That's a little nugget to note. All right. 17, 11, 8, all manageable. Void dice, injury dice, and stasis dice is the least of our concerns. Two health, so this has to go. And this is easy to clear. We can avoid the voids. Avoid the voids. I think that was the 7-Up slogan, right? That was the Noid. But same thing, same concept. Doesn't translate well between countries and languages. We can avoid the voids with the assists and probably gain more assists. Or we can just go here now. No, we'll do this. We'll clear this with Kayla, bank assists, bring Gene into the medical unit, hopefully clear the 11 and go back to full health. And then the 2 other people can take care of the 17. I think that's the best way to go here. I could even give Gene HP in here if all the rolls go right. Let's see what we get. Save the 4s. All right, there's our 8. Diminishing returns on the assist, though, I'd only get 1. So I think I'm going to give Gene and Kayla HP. Now Gene doesn't really need to go to the medical bay too hard. Bring the 5 down there. Got the 4 hardest dice to get there. Not hardest, but you don't really want to sacrifice a 6 down there when you can use it towards the event or towards any of the specialties. So the trickier ones we've got down here. Any one and two, and we can prevent injuries. So if we get like a unfortunate RNG next round, where there's just injury dice everywhere, we can probably consider using that. See, now I can bring Gene down there. Still has low HP. If I run out of the assists, it's a problem. And 11 with 3 dice is a little hard. About a little less than 4 per die I have to roll with only one reroll. Pascal has 5 dice though, but I could also take him to farm to do something else. Allison would sustain damage if she comes through here, and Jean's useless on the 17 as well. So I think we just try to clear this with Jean. Not worry about banking an extra die or health recovery though. So that was a good roll and then turned into a bad roll. Let's keep the 4 at least. And hope this averages out to 7. And it does not. It's 10 total. Someone else has to come in here. If that's the case, then we put 8 towards the repair. We'll put the 2 down here and we'll get out. The Noid was Domino's. Okay. Yeah, that's right. Good call, Duke. The Noid was Domino's. Spot was 7 up. Yeah, that was my bad. Well, maybe Domino's would be more, 7 up would be, more famous if they used the Noid. Who knows? You can't go back and rewrite history. We're taking Allison into the 17 event. It's stasis die, but she has the extra rerolls to make it work. They both have the same amount of health, so the injury dice are a problem. And they both can't benefit from the, 2 things. They both can't benefit from the extra health that this module's specialty provides. And they really both can't benefit from the specialty in this module that is regain dice. It would be diminishing returns, but it will keep them at 5 dice. But yeah, I think Pascal here. Look, we've already established the fact that we don't mind if we injure Pascal. I think we've made that clear already. I think he notices that too. Oh boy! Oh man! What was that? That was like every 1 in 3 I could roll ever. In like one sitting. Rip Pascal. Oh man. That was harsh. Who saw that? Everyone saw that, I'm sure. Well, that certainly changes things. We could live if we sacrifice that 2 health. We could also live if we sacrifice getting rid of, sacrifice not repairing this damage. We can live either way. This is only a 3. So with assists, we can easily take care of this next round. Without assists, we could already prove that we can just, roll a full house on like the worst numbers ever. That's the Tharsis headshot is what that is. That's a bad job. Assists are important sometimes, and sometimes they're just meaningless when you don't roll a 1 and a 3. Oh man, that was awful. All right, I think we take care of this damage here. 17 is a high number to leave lingering. I don't want to really build up events that cause the ship damage. We're only 3 weeks away. Let's take care of this and hope we just don't roll 1s and 2s and then both events are lingering to next round. Let's hope we don't roll 1s and 2s. So both events are not lingering towards next round. What is this? They know I'm on a winning streak, right? Like, I think the RNG was just, like, tweaked mid-game here. Well, I tell you what we do. I mean, what's the difference if it's 17 or if it's 9, right? Like, I'm very tempted to add the plus one chip here and then replenish the one and the two and then just use the two towards, like, one towards repair, one towards regain dice. Like, that's very, like, on the top of my mind right now, because... because that was terrible. We set this up so that we could prevent injury next turn. We also have plus one dice to all crew now. We can go maximum dice with Allison next round, not have to worry about food. And bring that down to 16. That is, wow. That is like an XCOM-like level of just everything's going right and then everything's just going wrong at the same time.
None of this makes any sense. It keeps changing. Is this real? Is this something that's happening now or something that's going to happen? Can we stop it? And if so, how?
Well, my streak of taking four crew members to Mars is over, but let's hope the win streak is not over. Plus one food, minus two ship. We just put plus one in the ship. That's tempting. It leaves us with two ship HP, and our mechanic is dead. We might actually eat our mechanic this turn, but we don't gain his special abilities through osmosis or whatever it is. Minus 30 stress, minus one health for you. Minus one health for all crew. Oh, boy. Minus one health for all crew kills Gene. So these two choices are pretty bad. Minus two ship puts us really low in HP, but doesn't kill another crew member. Survivability, we have to take that. All right, you're eating food, and you're going to eat Pascal here. So everyone's going to roll maximum die. All right, let's just throw everything at us now. So this is where it becomes to everyone's complaint that everything just stacks up on you. I'm pretty sure I'm going to use prevent injury. Everyone's at max dice. If I use prevent injury, then I can roll pretty much anywhere. I have to take care of the minus two all. And then I have to find a way to keep the ship alive, which I think then means moving Allison into this maintenance area, farming for ship health, and taking care of this. So I can get a maximum of three ship health and take care of this. I can live to see another day. And I could also maybe clear out something else. I don't think I can get that leak warning and this. Maybe Allison goes down there to stand the better chance for the leak warning. But you really have to roll 6, 5, 5, 5, 5 to clear that. First things first, we prevent injury. We bring Kayla. Gene's going to kill this minus two health all. But any two... wow. Any two... any two dice that show up one or three right now will kill Gene. But if I do Kayla first, she'll take one injury damage to get in here. Possibly use the assist, but possibly we can bank two research die so that Gene can immediately use this on this module, risk no damage, and get to full health. Worst case scenario then is we have to move Allison to here to roll for ship health or keep Allison... I don't even know. Like, Allison can't roll a 26. And unless we get another card that repairs modules, we're going to have to choose between one of these two, and it's probably going to be this one. Because it's lower. So, Kayla's going to take the damage, come in here. Staying away from the ones, please. Alright. That is actually fantastic. Sort of. We're going to bank the fives. I just need a single five. No, I don't. I need doubles here. Including double fives. Alright, so what is this now? This would be 13 towards the ship repair and 2 ship health. Or... well, we have to take care of this ship damage. And then we have to come in here and farm for ship health anyway. We do this so Gene can go... man. Well, we do have to take care of this minus 2 health loss. Health all. It affects everyone. So that's like a no-brainer. Use that so we don't risk damage. And then just roll. Roll for dice, roll for health. There's dice and health. One health all crew, one die all crew, no movement damage. Oh boy. Health recovery. Die for next turn. 2 on the research. And leave module. Okay. There's only one way we get out of this, is if we bring Allison here and roll 3 of a kind. That will give us 3 ship health. And then I think we're pretty much done next turn anyway. Unless we get something really favorable that's like minus 1 health for all crew members, plus 2 ship HP. She's going to take the damage because she's going to run through an event to get there. Yeah, there's no other way. So we need 3 of a kind. I mean, really, there's no sense holding on to them to re-roll. So we need a 5. Last chance 5. Oh, look at that. We're done. We did it. We did it. I'm going to do plus 1 all crew just in case one of the options is minus 2 health. And then bank the 3. See what this round has in store for us. I think we're done though. Last round.
We've almost made it. After all we've been through, there's no turning back. It's a suicide mission.
Plus 3 ship, but minus 5 health for you. Kayla, you might die. You might sacrifice yourself for the crew. Minus 5 health, but 2 food. That's useless. And minus 30 stress, minus 1 health. That's that would probably be the normal choice if we were in a position to win. But I think getting that 3 ship health is good, because at least then I can roll for ship health with like Allison or something. And then run. See, on the last round, you have to have somebody in this module. I don't know if you have to beat the module, though, but you have to have someone in this module. And your destruction must not be imminent. You have to have HP left after the round's over and the damage is incurred. So let's do this. Kayla, you're fine. You've been good. Let's eat people to get maximum dice, and let's finish and let's see what nasty stuff we get. Alright, so here's explaining. You have to be in the flight control and survive the turn, but it doesn't say it just says the ship must not be destroyed, not that you have to clear the module. So we need one ship health. One. That's it. And then Jean can haul ass over here, take all the damage in the world. We don't have to worry about using a no movement damage card. And then Jean, the captain, can land on Mars, just like Ched. When he's a sniper in XCOM, he makes it so that everyone else dies and he's the only one that survives. Jean is basically the Ched Omir of Tharsis right now. He will survive as long as Allison rolls for ship health. Any doubles. Windstreak is alive. As long as I'm not forgetting something. So, Allison, thank you for your service. Gene is going to go run to here. There's injury dice here. I have assists, and I have a decent amount of health. But when I run to here, I'm going to have two less health. So, it is kind of scary. I can use the no damage card, though. No movement damage card. And move to here for free now. Interesting, I have to click off there once I use the no damage card. But... Gene can move here, and as long as I don't roll 5 twos 7 times, if I roll 7 twos total in 2 rolls, I will be okay. I will leave, and Gene will live. So, I'm gonna bank these. I'm still gonna try to, like, there's two things I can do here. One, I can have my mouse go in and out every single time I play this game, and then have to redetect before I can move it. The second thing I can do is I can throw a lot of dice in research projects and just keep farming research projects on this last turn. It goes a long way towards achievements and unlocking a new character. But I think I want to try to at least clear this, so I need a 5 or a 6. Good. I got a 5 and a 6, so yeah, haha, RNG. It doesn't matter what I do here. I'm just going to clear this just on the off chance that I have to survive the ship. Survive with ship HP and clear the module so it can land. So we'll do this. We'll at least get one research projects. You get more points if you stack things in here and end your turn, but we're not worried about points right now. We need achievements. So Mars, everyone.
Travel to the horror, but I'm not sure any of us made it out the other side. The journey changed us.
So that's Tharsis, baby. So basically what happened there was Jean, it was trapped on an island, and everyone else was waiting in Purgatory, which was Mars, for him to be the last one to die. And then they all met back up, and they laughed, they hugged, and then fans of the series got pissed. I think that's what happened. But here's our points. 1356 is not bad. I've been in the 16 and 1700s before. 10 turns survived, 40 events completed, 1 crew member landed on Mars. That's the first time we've seen an ending, though, on my videos that wasn't everyone landing on Mars, and it was a little bit different. 6 health to end the game, 8 dice. 8 dice to end the game? I don't know what that means. You can only roll 5. 3 ship hull. I don't know what that means either. But 1 food, 2 dead crew, 5 human meals. Oh, okay. It was counting the other person in the ship as being alive as well, but not landing on Mars. And 5 human meals. Stress was ridiculous, and there we go. So that was Tharsis.